shady. And I'm not Rob Dyrdek.
Okay.
I'm not Mac Miller.
Okay.
So, yeah, contrary to popular belief, I am this Mike. The word teenager didn't even exist 100 years ago. There was no such thing. There was adolescence and adulthood. And once you were, 15, you were working in the shop, you were working on the farm, you were helping take care of the young ones at home.
In many ways, like an adult, in many ways.
Right, you were like a little adult. And so there was no such thing as a teenager. And the actual word teenager didn't develop until the invention of the car. And when kids were 15, 16 and got their driver's license and were able to leave home in an automobile with another, person of their age, that's when the whole idea of teenagers actually sprung up. See, people that would come into the teen center where I worked and go, "Oh my gosh, I wish we had this in our town. Yeah. Our teenagers don't have anything to do." Mm-hmm. Going, really? Really? No, that's the adults not owning this, not being proactive enough to guide a 15-year-old, 13-year-old into something that is extremely rewarding, something that takes hard work. It's like putting a Band-Aid on the Hoover Dam. But this would be the first year that I'm full bore being a speaker at schools and events, church retreats, things like that. And so it's just slow and steady, continue to get my book in people's hands. I've moved about 500 copies of it so far in only a few months, so it's exciting.
Yeah.
One neat thing that I want to go ahead and develop and get out there that several people have asked me about is developing a short curriculum for schools to use with this book. And so the young people will read the book, the advisors will read the book, and then have this kind of a curriculum that they go through as they read it or after they've read it, where they're able to even more process their own life and their own situation and help make sense of who they are and why they're here.
Please hang up and try again.
The thing is that your life is a jigsaw puzzle and that it comes together one piece at a time. And please quit getting so caught up in one piece when it's actually a part of something bigger. And it's hard to do when you're 15, is to see beyond what I'm doing this afternoon.
How do you feel about child work laws and all that stuff?
Oh, I would love to see kids working. I ran this gigantic teen center at the Y here in my town for a few years, and I would always give kids little jobs to do, but we would pay them in cafe cash. So they would get these little coins that they could use at our little snack bar and get a slushie or a pretzel or something.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say, hey, go sweep off all the leaves from the back patio, or hey, can you help me clean out this closet, or help take these items up to the main Y building? And they would earn this little cafe cash, and I loved it because they were doing something instead of sitting on the couch texting or playing another video game.
Yeah, and I think there's a lot to say for self-respect when you are earning your own money, earning your own way, and you're being useful.
Mm-hmm.
That it really, I think that's actually where self-esteem comes from. It doesn't actually come from someone telling you, "Hey, you're great, and way to go, and here's a trophy for showing up." It's actually like where you realize you've made a difference.
Well, there's one line that I use when I talk, and it's towards the end of my talk after I've shared a lot of stories and a lot of ideas and thoughts and metaphors and interactive little games that we do and things with the group, me and the group. I will say this. I'll say, if you always do what you've always done and you always think what you've always thought, then you will always get what you've always gotten. And you'll always be what you've always been. A life that goes from zero to hero is going to get that way when the good choices start outweighing the bad choices that you make.
great to keep in touch and
see
what you're up to, you know, maybe 6 months or whatever. And well, I'll call you back up and we'll do this again.
I would love it. I would love it.
Thanks so much.
And thanks so much for the opportunity. It's really a pleasure.